But yeah, there are definite differences. Not just because of the left-handed, right-handed mix-up that we have, but also the way they take on their shots. But both have phenomenal flicks, very strong backhands and forehands.
One all.
Both players who don't feel too much pressure to pivot initially. Because of how complete they are. But it's a serve receive. Lin Wenru has the best serves I've ever seen.
2-1.
Actually had a chance to receive them in Busan.
You did.
He made me look like a right fool. Unbelievable.
But what were his serves like?
So spinny, so deceptive.
1-3.
Okay. So serves were tough.
Yeah, unbelievably so. Francisco is one of the very, very few players that have managed to beat Ma Long, Fan Zhendong, and Xu Xin. And now, because the Cloudwalkers retired, no one can try and do that.
I'd retire after beating those three, actually. That's him.
Well, Lin's beaten Fan Zhendong and Ma Long, but never Xu Xin. But obviously now kind of Wang Qichin's in that big three, of course. Yi Sang Su, another one who'd managed to do that. Good start here from the Silent Assassin.
Five, two.
Yeah, we saw Chinese Taipei take on Germany, didn't we, in the recent World Team Championships. These two didn't face off, but my word, what a...
2-6.
That was one of the most impressive performances I've seen by a team, Chinese Taipei, how they dispatched what is a massively talented German team. Team that got to the finals in the previous... Well, chaps,
The 3-0 didn't tell the whole story because there were some epics between, especially Shuang and Dang Cho, and Lin and Ovcharov, as you said. Great third ball combo there from Francisco. Nice serve.
6-4.
That was a good position, wasn't it, for Lin Wenru to finish off?
No, it was tough though. Look how. Tried to take it on from extreme forehand with his backhand flick. In many fans' minds, he's got the best flick in the world, Lin Wenru, the Chiquita. It's a really iconic shot. Nice construction as well there. Big point, because it seemed like Francisco started to rev it up slightly.
Yeah. Good to see a good crowd in already. 70% full. Mid-afternoon. That's a great sign.
4-8.
There'll still be some tickets available, so hopefully we'll see you down here at the Infinity Arena. Last few days of the school holidays as well, so parents wanting to spend as much time with their kids and maybe bring them down here as well. Good way to bond. Oh, lovely from Lin Wenru. I mean, when you look at him, as you say, he has bulked up a little bit, but he's kind of the silent assassin's a perfect name for him. 6 of 8 as well for the Chinese Taipei star.
10-4.
And it's hard to be swift if you're big. I mean, Francisco moves so actively well. To say he's a pretty thick-set guy, but Lin Wenru here.
6 game points. Oh, effortless from Lin Wenru.
It almost takes a once-in-a-lifetime performance in terms of how you need to execute, calibrate your shots to beat him.
Oh, look at that shot.
One love.
Oh, talked about the quality. He adjusted himself brilliantly.
I mean, look at that for a fanning backhand from Francisco, the angle of it. But it's the feeling, it's the intimacy between him and the ball. It's just so in tune.
Love two.
Well, he's got to do something, Francisco. Ross, this is going to start becoming difficult. Look at that already. 13 of 16 have gone to Liverpool Road.
Oh, windscreen wiper.
Yeah, he really, that just takes the pace right off, doesn't it?
Well, from where he was, that might have been one of the only shots he could play, because Francisco countered well with another fanning backhand with side spin. But what feeling from Lin Winroo. Yeah. He's purring here, isn't he, with his cat-like movement.
Such a great touch player.
Come on, drop. 3-1.
I mean, when he's in full flow, Lin Winroo, as you said, very few can get near him. Look at that, again. There's a little subtleties as well.
There really is. Well said.
Two, four.
Wow. Of points won on serve. That, by the way, that's only gone to 90 just because of that last point which he lost. That's phenomenal. We're about a game and a half into this match.
A receiver like Francisco, one of the best receivers we've seen in the modern day game, can only win 10% of points on the receive. That has just epitomised the greatness of Lin Winroo's serve.
6-2.
And in real terms, that's 1 point that he's won. And actually, Fraser, having faced Lin Winroo, you're not so bad. Did all right, didn't?
I got back one of them and it was a let card. But now I feel fantastic about that.
You and Francisco can go commiserate with each other then.
Six.
Don't put me in the same boat as Francisco Shazad.
Yeah, you're a yacht. You're more of a yacht guy, I think.
Net. 6-3. Six-three.
3 point cushion here for Lin Winroo.
Come on! 4-6.
Well, we saw Francesca sort of come alive around this stage of the last game. Only trails by two.
Because of the suffocating nature of Lin's serve, you almost have to set yourself, I'm going to have to play a counter on this fourth ball. He just gets in every single time.
He's trying to move him around the table, and it's not really having the desired effect.
Just thread it through the eye of a needle, Lin Winroo.
Placement has been brilliant from him. Well, that is a great serve. Nice variation. It's a bit of an element of surprise there.
Fortune favoured the Brave. Great fighter, Franziska. Keeps his chin up. You can see how proud he is to be representing Germany. To have a chance to fight out here. You really sense that he treats the pressure as a privilege, but regardless of that, what can you do against a player like this from time to time?
You know, also, the fans, I think, appreciate Franziska, because there were quite a lot of them out there when he was signing autographs. And we know Lindman Roos certainly has a lot of fans too. And they've been a real treat, hasn't it, for everyone who's come down here to the Singapore Smash. We've got the Smash Park where you have got pick-up games, you've got meet the star opportunities,
5-10.
Food trucks. It's a real carnival atmosphere. This is your first Singapore Smash, and you've really enjoyed it. I know you've had quite a bit of a walk around, haven't you?
I think a carnival is a great word to describe it.
Well, it's a party right now as well for Lindman Roos. He's up by two here. That's the kind of rally that all these fans want to see.
The explosivity is just mind-blowing. All the side and top spin. But because of how good Lindman Roos has been behind his serves, you know Franziska has to convert behind his. I think Franziska needs to serve slower and wider, and then has to go for something pretty bold on his third ball. He has to try and open up the table immediately for himself. So I'd go slower and wider with the serves. Especially into the forehand, make it tough for Lindman Roos to flick. And touch with love and push with quality. Just make him have to move as soon as possible, really.
Well, that's why we're having a timeout here.
Love 5.
I mean, this is a procession of points right now for Lindman Roos. Remember, it was Franziska who had the tie break. And the first two have gone to Lindman Roos since then. Make that 6-3.
There might not be a more beautiful player to watch.
Not just working off some of that excess energy that he's got.
Not as well.
We'll have him right here in the Infinity Arena against Sharad Kamal Achanta. I mean, that is, for me, one of the most intriguing matches of the day.
Yeah, that's just lip-smacking.
Yeah. Oh, wow, this is 25, make it now 26 of the last 33 points. He hasn't scored one here at all, Franziska, in the third game.
One
well, he has now, but that's total dominance from Lindman Roos.
And it all happens under the radar. Is that good? You look towards whoever you sat next to and start talking about him, and you look back and he's 8-0 up.
I was just going to ask, I mean, of the non-Chinese players in the top 10, do you think he's the biggest threat?
I think so. I think Lindman Roos is the biggest threat to Team China.
9-2.
And again, about that Champions Frankfurt where Lindman Roos took the world by storm, no one out of everyone he played, Duda, Hadamoto, Wang Chichin and Malong included, took him closer than Franziska. But look at what's happening here.
I mean, this has been a masterclass so far, hasn't it?
Stand and deliver. Outstanding.
I just saw Roscoff there just puff out his cheeks.
11-2.
That is one of the most impressive games I've seen on that rather than actual pure stats. So you're saying stylistically,
Love
this one is the kind of player that would cause problems for Chinese players.
He has, and you imagine will continue to. Got his eyes on Olympic medals, Lin Minru. Could already be a bronze medalist if it wasn't for Dmitry Ovcharov, who beat him in Tokyo.
One.
And he nearly beat Fan Zhendong in the semi-final there. We could already be talking about Lin Minru as an Olympic silver medalist if that one game decided would have gone the other way.
1-3.
She's very good from Franziska here. He's having to go a little bit further back here to have any chance of survival, because the closer he stays, the harder it is for him to actually calibrate a counter against the rotation of Lin Minru. Franziska is familiar with Lin, not just because they've played each other quite a lot of times, but because Lin Minru's spent some time playing in Germany.
Yeah, that surely would have stood him in good stead, as it has with many players. It's a top European league, isn't it?
But you think that kind of familiarity would help Francisco out, but seems to have had very little effect. It's all about how you perform on the day, what kind of mood you're in.
Come on.
And Lin Minru is in the mood. And, of course, we know he's someone who likes to let his table tennis do the talking. That's another intimidating thing. When your opponent barely gives any reaction.
This is about as much as you get.
Yeah. As soon as I say it.
Yeah, exactly. But, hence the silent assassin nickname. But here we are, Fraser, in this the old fourth game syndrome in a best of seven. And Patrick Franziska, with his best start so far to any of the games, he has been completely outplayed in the preceding three.
Come on!
6-4.
And he's finally showing what he can do. Chop block actually setting up Franziska nicely in the end.
Three. 6-5.
I wonder whether Lin Minru can finish us off in four. It's a massive statement, isn't it, as well? For a man who's beaten both Ovcharov and Ma Long in the same event.
5-7.
Well, the winner of this match will face whoever wins out of Timo, the legendary German ball, and Dapat Liang Jingquin, who is, of course, the only Team China player remaining this half due to Ball's win over Lin Shidong.
Another great result.
The Lion Cub beating the Lion King and world champion Fan Zhendong in the round of 32.
The team of ball isn't apparently 100%. Yeah, quite a few players feeling the strain here in Singapore. Zhang Wujin is another. And that's a real shame that one of the semi-finals is now a walkover. The men's doubles.
7-4.
Swift attack from Lin and he levels up. That's not even a bad receive. Imagine getting punished for something you didn't even do wrong.
Oof. It's happened to all of us. Yeah. We've been on the receiving end as well.
Four, come on.
Hit 7.
Francisca just in front.
That was well done there from Francisca to play the parallel on the lunge. It was a deeper chop block from Lynn, but still kind of high enough for Francisca to do it. And there we
see
some more authoritative play from the German.
Yeah, lovely shot from Francisca.
Eight, nine.
Less. This one. Still alive, maybe. And he was at 100% Lehman Root. Only 76% now. The points won on serve. Still very, very impressive.
Oh.
10-8.
Well, he was putting those away for fun earlier. And now Francisca has two game points.
Got away with murder there, Francisca.
Yeah, this one. The way he's been playing here today, Lindman Root, you can imagine he would have put that away.
Ten, nine.
Well, well. Still been a pretty good event for Germany.
Never nine.
But Francisca has taken.
One love.
It's still looking like Timo Boll will be the last German standing here at the smash. But Francisca has the personality, has the minerals to make a comeback.
Love the old minerals.
One love.
Wondering when they'd make an appearance.
One all.
But it's over the period of time that he's going to have to do it. How do you keep that level there? Because Lynn's going to be changing things. Look at this.
Well, as you said, it's you can't recall yourself when you've last seen someone come back from three down.
A smash at the Singapore smash.
It's tough at this level against a player like Lin Winroo.
There has been a German to have beaten Lin Winroo from 3-0 down before. And it was Ruin Phyllis in the final of the WTT contender Almaty.
1-3.
That was a 3-0-2. Three up there. Lin Winroo. Very, very good. Result that one was. Remember it like yesterday.
2-3.
Came back and won it the year after, of course, beating Jampang in the final.
Yeah, someone finished business for him with that one. So he's back in front here, Lin Winroo. Was that
five
serve that
two.
Just really kept him very much cramped for space here. Look at this. Right into that midriff area. Really nothing you can do about that.
Five, two.
Right into the belly button. If he had an outie, he's now got an innie.
Six.
Not looking good this for Francisco.
No, it's almost like normal service resumed again for Linwood Root after a little aberration in the last game.
The timeout did wonders for Francisco, but he's not got another one. Only get one per match across.
I wonder whether Lin might just take one here if Francisco continues to get points.
Seven, three.
It's a decent lead, isn't it? 4 points. Four away also from winning the match. Both that reached the quarterfinals at last at the Singapore Smash in 2022.
Eight, three.
This win here will take Linwood Root above Hugo Calderano. We'll take him above Lin Gaoyuan.
Well, Felix Lebrun is also playing still in this event.
4-9.
So they both might be. Well, presumably, if Linwood Root is going to crack the top five, then so would Felix Lebrun.
Felix Lebrun is just about 140 points above him.
10-4.
So, 6 match points for Linwood Root here against Patrick Francisco.
Let 10-4.
And that is a fantastic win for Linwood Root, who's completely outplayed.